bringing the good news of God, what God has to say to his lovely people, and also to encourage you in this end days. Don't lose hope, just keep on keeping on. I mean, focus, just have a purpose in this life. Have something that you aspire to do, have something that you love to do. I mean, to have fun, entertain yourself, and also be wise like a serpent. I mean, have friends, but then from afar, be the indoor type of person in this end days that we are in, okay? Because we are in the days of Noah. We are in the days of Noah. If you are to know what is happening lately, you know that this world is actually a dangerous place to be, right? So, but the Lord still protects his children. The Lord still advises others the steps of his children. And I believe you believe and you know that God is still for you. All right, once again, I want to tell you that don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. Be focused. Whatever you plan to do, whatever you want to do, just have the aim. Just have whatever you want to do. Be focused in life. Limit your interactions with people, okay, because you have energy vampires, right? So, the Lord has just encouraged you that he's still with you. He still blesses you every day and end. You just have to limit your associations with people and how you talk to people, whatever you tell people, and how don't care about anybody, what anybody will think of you, but what only God will think of you. Have a purpose, first of all. Fear God, always pray. Put on the armor of God. The armor of God, you can Google it and learn more about that. And then always pray to God Almighty and live in these end days. Okay, that doesn't stop you. You say, we came in this world to multiply. Whatever you see around here, we are the children of God. We are the originators, right? So whatever here belongs to us. Okay, forget about whatever is happening, the Nephilims that I told you guys about, the demons that are walking around. See, because when you know what is in you, you know he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. You understand that you are a purpose child, you are a mission child. Okay, so nothing shall by any means harm you. Okay, this is the word of encouragement for today. Like, share, and subscribe, and let others also be blessed as you have been blessed. All right, so today's topic actually, I actually want to talk about the offices in the, let's say, the fellowship of God in this Christian life, the belief, the faith of Jesus Christ, the offices of everybody, okay? What everybody is assigned to do and what are our job and our purposes, okay? Some are called musicians, some are called worshippers, some are called preachers, some are called pastors, some are called prophets, apostles, teachers, bishops and all that, right? So what I want to tell you is that today's topic, I want to talk about the offices of what the Christian life, the children of God. Now there are two main ones that I want to talk about, because most of it all comes from all the two that I'm coming to talk about. We have the offices of the pastor, the pastoral offices, which to me is under the teachers, the preachers, the apostles and the evangelists and all that. And then we have the particular office, which is called the prophetic office, the office of the prophets. Okay, the office of the prophet, like Samuel and all other people that we know about. People who came to prophesy the coming of Jesus, okay, John the Baptist, for me, I would say also, because he was able to communicate with God, he was able to know that the Son of God was the one standing in front of him, so you should know that he was not just a normal person, okay? So, you should know that we have prophets like Elijah, Elisha, they came what they came to do. So, we have prophets, we have different types of prophets and what they are here to do, okay? So, and now, I just told you the two main topics that all the pastoral and all over the offices in the kingdom of God align, okay? And I fall under, sorry. We have the pastoral office, and then we have the prophetic office. All right, thank you very much. life is, let me make it very short for you to understand some things. Okay, I like clarifying things. I like talking about things. For a pastor would like to gather as many people as possible. Okay, a pastor would like to go to places, be known, be do this and be do that. A pastor would like to go to places, have a church, go here, talk to everybody and all that. Of course, there are fake pastors. They have Nephilims who have stolen the destinies of true children of God, who later died or something. You see, who later died or something, okay? So that's it. So, and then there are true children of God who are what? Pastors. They also want to preach to everybody. They do the work of God. Like the ones, the temples, okay? The ones that Jesus Christ went to tell who to give the offerings to and who to not to do all. Okay, there were pastors, there were, you know, in those days, there were temples of God and all that. So, that is what the pastor would do. To preach the word of God, to preach, to remember people, to remind people of what? Of the coming of Jesus Christ, the Ten Commandments, I mean, the importance of what? The afterlife, the judgment day and all that, okay? So, that is what the pastor does. Yes, these are what the office is, what the duties of what the pastor is supposed to do, to always remind people of the Ten Commandments, the salvation, you know, all that. Good. Now, for the prophetic, prophetic office, as for the prophet, I'm not saying they don't also preach or gather people, but I want to show you their specific thing that they do. A prophet always knows that we are all in battle. We are not humans. A prophet knows who to talk to and who to deliver a message to in particular. A prophet would go directly to deliver a message. A prophet always comes out only when a message or a warning or a blessing or some clarification is needed. Something is needed to be what? To be out. That is what a prophet does. So, a Nephilim can walk with a prophet. A demon can be with around a prophet. That prophet will not actually preach, but that prophet will actually what? Use always the sword of the spirit, because those people, when you always around them, the prophet listens and sees that they are full of what? Curses, mockery, energy sucking, because some people can sit around you and just suck in your energy. Do you understand? So, energy sucking and all that. So the pastor will sit around you, feel the way you are sucking the energy and thinking you are just sitting there, see you, and then you will rather sit down and listen for you to preach to him or her, the prophet. And then it looks like a comedy. Do you understand? Yes, because the Bible says that, John 8:44, for like their father, they are lying. So they are children of God and they are children of Satan. A prophet knows that they are children of God and they are children of Satan, no matter what. And we are in a battle. So a prophet will not just come and preach. A prophet preaches only when there is a message to be delivered that will touch a lot of many people. That a pastor always gather people on Sunday, on Wednesday, or occasion day, which now there are a lot of fake pastors and fake prophets. But let me tell you how the true prophet used to operate. They don't see you and see things. When you come to them, they will tell you, I'll come back to you. They will pray. See your vision in a dream and come and tell you later. That is how God operates. So if you go to a prophet and they tell you plain, I can see this. They are magicians, okay? They are Nephilims trying to lure you to something that you don't want, okay? So many of us are deceived by magic and all that, but I'm here to remind you that that is not how a prophet operates. A true prophet of God operates by what? Dreams, not by vision. And I can see you are wearing this. You can know. They can see your destiny around you because they have evil eyes. They are demons. Okay? So watch out. Watch out in these end days and be blessed. So the difference between a prophetic in the spiritual realm and then the pastoral, that is it. So a prophet only delivers.